So we're going to be doing Capricorn Ascendance today. Talk about one hell of a disciplinarian from the outside, yet very soft and lack of willpower from the inside. So Capricorn Ascendant, Capricorn Rising Sign, who are they? Well, first of all, what is Rising Sign? Rising Sign is pretty much the sign that was rising during the time of your birth on the eastern side. Because see, it's evening and the sun is right there on my face, and it's getting on my face really brightly. But that's the east. So when the time you were being born, as soon as you came out, and there was Capricorn rising from the where sun rises on, that becomes your rising sign, your ascendant, which is far important than your sun sign, your moon sign, because an ascendant maps your entire life. What kind of career you might run into, what kind of siblings relationship you might have, what kind of a home environment you might have, what kind of, you know, a wife or husband you might get. So this is why it's very important that if one understands what an ascendant is, because it's quite important. So let's find out who these guys are. Well, Capricorn people are very disciplined people, very calculative people, okay? These guys are very careful about everything that they do in life. But also, more importantly, Capricorn ascendant people are always seeking rank in life because of the fact they suffer such a low self-esteem and such an lack of ego within themselves, and a lot of fluctuation of ego within themselves, that they need to go to a higher rank in life in order to feel sustained, and in order to feel sustainable in life. Why? Because Saturn rules Sun, who's the arch enemy of the ascendant Saturn, is ruling the 8th house of sudden changes. And Saturn and Sun is a signifactor of ego, it's a signifactor of self-esteem. So there's a battle that goes on. So even though Saturnian people look very, you know, confident and very much, you know, intellectual from the outside, from the inside they're kind of hollow, because they're having this battle of ego and self-esteem from within. But let's find out how their family and their, you know, assets are like, their all the other environment in their life. Now Capricorn people, you know, they can come from the family of intellects, family of intellectuals, especially scientific background. Like their father could be a research scientist, he could be an executive at a scientist science or lab facility, or a pharmaceutical company, you know. So the scientific research and the scientific way of, you know, living life becomes their family life. You know, their speech is very eloquent, their speech is very, you know, not dynamic, but it's able to win over people, because Aquarius is also ruled by Saturn. And so Saturn, who only wants to give speech very cautiously. So when they say something, they want to be right about it, and they want to make it articulate, and they want to make it unique. So these guys are very elegant in their approach to life, but whether it's themselves or their speech. And like I said, the family, you know, could be of a very intellectual environment in their family. And because of the second house is ruled by Saturn, they're very frugal with their money. Like they can be driving a Toyota, but in their bank, they will have $300,000 saved up, because the value of Saturn is being instilled in not only in their physical life, but also in their family life, in their speech, in their money, the assets, okay? When it comes to their siblings, dealing with their siblings, dealing with their everyday people, relatives, they're kind of indifferent about it. They're kind of have a spiritual outlook towards it, that, hey, if my siblings don't like me, fine, I'll stay away. My siblings wants to communicate with me, hey, come on, welcome, let's have a spiritual connection. You know, their relatives is the same thing. If their relatives do not like them and abandon them, fine, okay, it's life. So they have a very spiritual outlook towards us. So it's very mellow towards those things. Their home life, however, again, becomes a very strict environment. Their entire energy goes into communication with the family, because it's ruled by Aries. So there's a lot of a soldier mentality in the home, meaning that your dad or you yourself could, you know, carry weapons in your home. You can have those safe box with a gun, you may carry a knife. Your family must have gone through some sort of a physical harm, because of the fact Saturn and Mars are very chaotic planets towards each other. And in this ascendant, Mars, you know, rules this home life, which becomes a very disciplined, again, like in Aries, like that soldier who's always disciplined. Now their fifth house of entertainment, creativity, acting, cinema, children, education becomes very important, because Venus not only rules their fifth house of these things and speculative business, but also 10th house of career. And with Saturn ascendant being, you know, somebody who likes to be in authoritative position, these guys make very good executives in the media business. They can be very good producers. They can become very good film directors. Somebody behind the scenes, yet in the Venus world. Venus world is what? The entertainment world. And because Saturn nature is to be kind of dominant and take charge and be disciplined about these things, you need a good producer to make a show, to balance the budget, to make sure everybody's showing on time, so that Capricorn energy really transforms into being behind the scenes in things. You know, they can even make good lawyers, and we'll get to that later. But because Venus becomes a very important planet for these guys, they go into speculative business, but they want to be in charge of things. They really don't want to be in front of the camera. If it allows it, fine, they will go on. But they're mainly about presenting a beauty in front of people while they're behind the scenes, okay? Their litigation, enemies, everyday, you know, work life, you know, their diseases, all of it, you know, it's quite okay. It's quite neutral. Why? Because Mercury is ruling the sixth house. And Mercury is neutral to Saturn. So whenever they have a dispute, they're able to solve those disputes with their communication. This is why in litigations, lawyers, these kind of lawyers can do very good. They're able to win through any kind of jury. They can win through any kind of argument because of the Gemini energy in the sixth house. So they make good lawyers, good judges. And Saturn is all about the law. It's all about punishing after somebody has done something wrong, you know, broken the law. So they make good judges because of those things, okay? They make good people. And because of they're always wanting to see the higher rank, if they become lawyer, they will like, okay, what do I do to become a judge? So they make them good politician in that sense as well. Their marriage partner, their legal partnership kind of becomes a place where they look for emotional ties. They want their husband or wife to nurture them like a mother, to nurture them and be there for them like a mother. They want to be emotionally connected to them. Why? Because of the fact the Saturnian life that they were born with, the ascendant, their life was very disciplined all the time. The motherly love was very business-like. Their mother were business, actually. The mother could be a business authoritative personality because Moon, which represents the mother, is controlling the seventh house of, you know, business, legal partnership, you know, legal bindings. So mother was always busy into these things. So they never really felt nurtured in their life. Now, Sun rules their longevity, Sun rules their ups and downs in life, and their assets after marriage, and these things can fluctuate. And this is why their ego and their self-esteem fluctuate in their life. Why? Because Sun is ruling that house this time. So because they suffered such low self-esteem in life, because Sun is ruling the bad house, the eighth house of, you know, sudden changes, is that this is why they look for rank in life. This is why they want to stabilize that Sun by being at a higher rank. When it comes to the religion, their spirituality, their higher learning, they're very calculative about these things. They just don't believe things just because you tell them. No, they want to implement their own calculation that, okay, they're teaching me this, this, and this. And out of 10 things that they have taught me, I think I will take 3 of those and I'll believe in those. But I don't think the other 7 are right. So they're very calculative when it comes to their belief, when it comes to their higher learning. Career, again, Venusian energy. So working behind the scene, but in the beauty. With something, a very balanced career, but regarding beauty, regarding, you know, sensual things, regarding, you know, entertainment. So again, behind the scenes in the entertainment usually can be seen with the Capricorn ascendants. Now, when it comes to their networks, their social network and their gains, they're very secretive about that, okay? They usually keep their social circle to themselves. They're kind of secretive about those things, and their gains are kind of secret. So that means one day a husband might find that, oh my God, my wife has been investing in mutual funds all this time and we have so much money. And the wife will be like, yes, because you're such a spendthrift, who was a Capricorn ascendant wife, says, I was investing on the side just to make sure we are fine, we are well off. So they invest, and their gains become secretive. They have money hidden in places, and they're very secretive about who they let in their network circle. But when it comes to their spirituality and their meditation and their, you know, that other spiritual world, their imagination, their dreams, they are very, very spiritual because of the fact Jupiter is ruling their 12th house of spiritual energy, you know, where their losses are all about giving donations. They get big donations, you know. They're very much about believing that helping other people, they will gain more, because Jupiter instills this in them. Because Jupiter, the Sagittarius sign, is in the 12th house, and Jupiter is ruling the 12th house of siblings and communication, and you know, their willpower. But so most of their, you know, this is why Capricorn ascendant people, they look very strong in the front, but inside, in the back, they're kind of lack their willpower. They are very soft from the inside, pretty much. You know, they really need somebody to push them forward in order to get them to go where they want to. So usually these guys have a hand of a preacher, a hand of a priest behind them, a hand of a guru behind them, somebody who instills confidence in them. Okay, so their confidence and their spirituality is really governed by the teacher that they run into in their life. And remember, their kids, Capricorn ascendant kids, really they're raising the kids become exhausting. Their kids might turn, might actually be the cause of the losses. Like they might have to spend a lot of money on their kids. Why? Not because Venus is ruling their fifth house. No, the signifactor of children is Jupiter. In astrology, there's signifactors, like sun is a signifactor of your father, moon is a signifactor of your mother. Even the fourth house is the house of mother, which could be ruled by somebody else, like in our case, Mars. So this is why mother is a very dominating figure in their life. Okay, but the true signifactor of mother is the moon. So mother is very dominating and very businesslike. Just like this, Jupiter is the source of their exhausting their energy, but also it becomes a source of pushing them forward. Their courage, the third house, also comes from Jupiter. So guys, this was my analysis on Capricorn Ascendant. Hope you enjoyed it. If you're new to my channel, definitely subscribe above, because I'm gonna be bringing you all that you didn't know about astrology. And if you wanna know more about what I know about astrology, check out my link below, check out my book there, Astrology at the Speed of Light, and all my articles that are regarding all the aspects of your life, all right? See you tomorrow. Thank you.